Welcome back, guys, to another episode of Satisfactory. And on this episode, we're going to finish off Tier 3 by getting our transportation milestone unlocked, as well as our steel manufacturing milestone unlocked, which is basic steel production. We're going to get those done and get started building a steel production plant. So sit back, relax, and let's jump into it. So, with the Fixmas event that's on right now, there was one thing that got pointed out to me that I didn't realize, and I thought this was just a poster on the wall here, or like a monitor on the wall, but this is actually an advent calendar. So, I don't know if you noticed it, but we can open the advent calendar, and then I believe we have to find the days. So, there's 9, 2, 4, I'm looking for 1, 2, and 3. So 2 we can open because we do have 2. It's today's actually the 3rd for me when I'm recording this. When this episode will go live, I'm not entirely sure. So that's that one taken care of. 2 is done. Now we need to find 1 and 3. 17 is just up over here. Let's look. 7 is down here. There's 3. Oh, there's 3. That takes care of today, which got us a Christmas ball that we can put onto a Christmas tree. And then we're still looking for number 1 on here somewhere. I'm searching. 20 is right here. 23. Is that 1 right there? Could that be 1? No, that's not 1. Kind of looks like it might be a 1. Obviously 6 is right there. 17, we already did say that one. Well, how is this so difficult to find? 12? I see 12. 9, of course, we already touched base on. I'm like right up on the old screen here trying to see. 22 is right there. 10 is on the belt. 19 is on Dogo. 16's on this present. 25 is this great big gift that's right here. 20 is here. Why is number 1 so difficult to find? All right. Where are you hiding? You're hiding here somewhere. I know it's going to be here. Well, it's got to be here somewhere. 2 and 3 are done. Number 1 shouldn't be this difficult. Why is it so difficult? And you guys have probably already seen it, and you're like screaming at your monitors right now. It's right there. There's number 14 tucked in right there. This ain't fair. Here somewhere. Oh my goodness, it's right there. It's on Dogo's tongue. There is number 1. All right, so what did we get out of this? We got some Fixmas gifts. We got, oh wow, we got some coupons for the Awesome Sink that we can turn in at some point. I don't have the Awesome Sink built yet, but we'll definitely get that turned in. And then used for making Fixmas decorations, as we've got the Fixmas ornaments. So there's our first 3 of those taken care of on here. And that's just awesome that they've done that. Made this little advent calendar. And then of course, each day they will release another one. So the next time that I'm going to be doing some recording, I'll have to remember to pull off. Where did we say 4 was? I know I've seen it on here already. 14 was right there. I don't know. We'll get it. We'll get it later on when 4 is available. But we have 1, 2, and 3 done. Because at the time I'm recording this, it is December 3rd. But okay, today's mission. We are going to get, let's look at our tiers here. We're going to get vehicular transportation all out of the way. That's only going to be 25 more frames, and I got to go down and grab some iron rods. We have the rest of this stuff, so this is a non-issue. And basic steel, 50 frames and some concrete is what I got to do. We have the rotors and everything, so we're pretty much like set for this stuff. We just have to make sure we've got the frames. So I'm going to whip down to the frames and see if we got them there. Okay, so I just got back up to the hub up here, and I do have enough of the frames. Oh, but I didn't grab the concrete that I need. I could turn in this one, but I want to get the steel production started. So we're going to bust down and work at trying to get the concrete. I'm going to grab this concrete and turn it in, and then we'll be right back. Okay, I've been down. I've grabbed the modular frames and the little bit of concrete. I'm going to turn in the iron, or sorry, the steel production end of things, because I don't quite have enough modular frames. I've only got 59 modular frames, so it's going to keep working and grinding away on making those for us. But if we get this unlocked, we can start manufacturing our steel, which is going to give us some greater upgrades down the road here. So let's select this milestone and get this on its way. So we got modular frames. We've got rotors that we're putting up. We've got concrete that's going up. And then we have copper wire that we're sending. And launch away. We have done
milestone reached.
Our milestone for steel production.
Foundry grants access to new simple steel parts. An additional project part can now be constructed. Progress to the next phase is now possible.
Progress to the next stage is now possible. Okay, we can now make, let's have a look at this, is if we go to production, we have the new foundry here. Let's click on this and see, okay, what do we need to actually build this? Well, we need freaking frames. So I don't have enough frames on me. I'm short by one. Well, there should definitely be one over there now. We're gonna grab that frame and we're gonna put down one of these steel foundries and just gonna see what we need to actually make steel ingots. Because that's ultimately what it's gonna come down to that we're gonna need here. So let me run over here and grab this small little handful. It's not gonna be very many frames because I literally was just here and cleaned this out. If there's five here, I'd be maybe 10 at the most. 10, we got 10, there we go. Okay, let's actually put this down now. The foundry, we're just gonna slap it down here and see what it takes to actually make this thing work. Okay, what does it take? To make steel ingots, we need 45 iron per minute and 45 coal per minute for being able to make 45 steel ingots. Okay, I don't see an issue with any of that. Now, what I don't want to do is I don't want to end up taking away from any of my production that's happening down here or the production that's working on here. I know for a fact off that way, there are four normal iron nodes. So if I combine them and work at bringing them back here, we'll have basically enough to be like two pure nodes. So I can have 240 iron per minute coming over this way, iron ore. So I'm going to build a platform just on the other side of this and then go over and work on getting all of that iron ore back here to get it smelted into iron ingots for us so that we can, I want to build a big steel plant, big for me as far as, so it'll be a larger assembly area than what we've got here so far. So that's my goal. We have 60 coal sitting up there right now waiting, as well as another 120 coal that we're not even touching yet that we can bring down to this. So that's what we're going to work on getting here. And just hold on while I get this all rigged up and get some of the materials here. Okay, so I found the first two nodes. They're right here and here. And of course, these are just normal nodes. So the two of those combined will make basically a pure node. We'll be able to put them into 120 items. And then there's another one here and another one just over there. So we got four nodes kind of tucked in here all together. I'm going to do another quick little scan just to see if there's any more that's really close by. So there's the four there. Bang, 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 that we just found that have all shown up here. 13 meters, 58 meters, 30 meters. These ones... What's oh, there's another one right here. There's actually five? Huh, okay. There's also these dudes too, which are kind of a pain in the butt, so let's get rid of them. The little wasp bee things. I don't know. They are kind of a... They try to get behind you to attack. And they're really sucky when they get behind you, and they're kind of hard to hit, so... So there's another one here. Oh, there's also some of these Fixmas gifts. I'm going to grab the Fixmas gifts as well. So, I mean, if I can bring back three full lines of iron, that would be all right. I'm not going to complain about that too much. We're 2.5 right now because I'm pretty sure that this one here is also a normal iron node as well. And of course, that's just 60 items per minute. So yeah, it's normal as well. So we'll get these, we'll get a platform kind of set up here and get some miners rigged up. Oh, there's literally like three of those nodes right here. So there's three here and there's three right over there. So we will be able to send back 360 iron from here. I'm definitely going to do it because the iron's going to get used. I'll run three conveyors all the way back to make sure we get all of those materials there. Now, I mean, here, treks would have been good, but I mean, we're not that far. There's the elevator right there at our base. So we're not that far from the platform that I've got set up. So we'll get this rigged up. So I was actually mistaken. I've got three nodes right here, and then there's two nodes over here. The one that I thought was a third node over here, I believe this is actually limestone that's over here. It's not an iron node deposit. So really, we only have the 2.5 nodes. So I'll leave one of them for now, and then we will, you know, gather up. If we find another node, then I don't want to ship back just a 60 item. So we'll send back 240 items of iron. We'll leave this one for now. If we find another iron node that's like close by here, we'll feed it into that and connect it and then send back another 120. But for now, this is going to be fun. And there's like gifts laying everywhere around here. It's absolutely nuts. I've been running around gathering these up. I've got like tons of these Fixmas gifts in my inventory here. If I look at my inventory right now, let's tab. I have 390 of them so far. My inventory is just chock full of stuff. So I'm going to keep going at getting this set up and getting our line shot over to our base over there. Okay, so we have our four miners down there mining the normal iron nodes that are, we've got them combined to bring us back two lines of 120 items per minute. We bring them down here and then we do some little nifty kind of splitting here. Let me just climb up on this conveyor so we can kind of see what's going on. And I got to get onto that edge. There we go. So basically, we've got smelteries set up on this side. The foundries, sorry. The foundries are set up on this side. And I have four foundries set up there. Each foundry takes 45 iron ore. So to get an even distribution of 45 iron, I'm kind of doing a little bit of like maneuvering with some splitters and stuff here to try to get things to work out mathematically correct so we get a proper balance and 100% efficiency going into these foundries. So I am coming down with 120 items into this first splitter that's right here. 60 is going this way, 60 is continuing on to that one. This 60 gets fed into this merger, and then this splitter splits 30 off to that smelter that's over there, and 30 into this merger, which is giving me 90 iron ore. The 90 iron ore then goes into this splitter. We got 45 going into here and 45 going into here. Even split. Then I'm taking this second conveyor of 120 items, and I'm doing the exact same thing down here. We're going into a splitter. 60 goes off into that merger. 60 goes into another splitter that sends 30 over to the smelter and 30 into the merger, giving us a 90 total out of here. 90 then goes from here to that splitter and then splits off to two foundries that are over there. So that's taking care of all of our iron. And we're efficiently putting iron ingots into here. What we do with these iron ingots, I really don't have a thought on that yet. We'll deal with that here in a little bit, but we have a total of 180 iron ore going into the smeltery that's going in. So now I need 180 coal to be able to do this. So you remember in the last episode, I had some coal. You know what? I'll go up there and explain it, and then we'll figure out exactly what we're going to do. Just hold on while I run up there. Okay, I got up here to our coal area up here. So basically, we're using 90 coal per minute on our generators on this bank. And we run over to this side and we're using 90 coal per minute on this bank, which means that there is a total of 60 extra coal per minute coming off of this production line. Then we've got this extra node that's over here that is another 120 coal per minute that we're going to get off of this line here.
So basically, we'll be able to take this 120 line and run a full conveyor down, a Mark II conveyor down at 120 going down this way, and then a 60 conveyor line going down as well. And so the 60 item per minute are going to be flying down here as the secondary conveyor. Those combined give us 180. How much coal do we need for our foundries down there to make our steel? We need 180 coal. So we have the perfect amount of coal that we're going to be able to shoot down this way and get set up down there. It's just going to take some time to get all the conveyors and everything all laid out to make that happen. But I'm going to work on getting that done right now. And then when we're back, we should have the coal hooked up and then we'll be able to power everything up. Okay, so I nearly have the coal all the way down to where we gotta go. The problem is I ran out of reinforced plate. I gotta wait for the machinery to get caught up making me some more reinforced plate. I've used a ton on getting some Mark II conveyors down. So I actually just powered up this miner over here. It is now just starting to push the coal down here at 120 items per minute. The coal in this line is going down at 60 items per minute, which gives us a total of 180 items per minute. Now there's a nifty little thing that I'm doing at the bottom here that, oh, that's gonna hurt, that's gonna leave a mark. I gotta make sure I don't do that because, we don't have a lot of health. I should probably switch and feed myself something here. Give myself a few little bites to eat. Kind of hope that this coal catches up. I'm not sure how far back it is. It should be coming along. It should be just about cresting the hill there and coming down. So health is back up. Here it is. It's slowly coming along. So basically, down at the bottom of all this, where all these conveyors end up going through, I'm taking the lines here and I'm basically splitting them and then merging them. And I'll kind of explain. So basically, I need 90 per line to get an equal split over at the actual foundries when I get over there. And so the best way I figured to do it would be is if I take the 120 line that's at the bottom and I split it, and the 60 line at the top and I split it, and then I merge from each one of those, we get 90. So basically, you look at this little setup that I've got here. I've got two splitters stacked. The 120 line comes down into the bottom. 60 is going into this merger. And 60 is going out the other side and up to that merger, which gives 60 to each one of those. Then the 60 line that's coming down here comes into the splitter. It splits 30 this way, going down into this merger, and 30 this way. So you take 60 and 30, you add them together, what's coming out at this end is 90 items per minute on both lines. So now we have a nice equal split that when we get down there, it's just a matter of feeding them into pre-set up little splitters that are here. We just run one line into here and another line into this one. And then one line feeds two foundries and the other line feeds two foundries, and then we've got our coal set up. But of course, I'm completely out of reinforced iron right now, so I'm kind of at a little bit of a standstill until that gets caught up. I'm probably just gonna leave the game logged in tonight, so when I come back tomorrow, there'll be a whole pile of iron there and we'll be able to wrap things up for, you know, getting our steel manufacturing going. So before we get back to our coal and steel production, I did run up here and I've got it set up so that the Christmas gift stuff is getting put into a constructor to make us those Christmas leaves. And I know I got enough leaves now that we can actually go and throw down our Fixmas tree. So we are where am I going to put this? I'm going to put it up on this hillside. Right up here, because they're actually pretty big. There we have a Fixmas tree. And I think we have like one ornament, I think, that we can use on it. I'm not even entirely sure that we can use it on it, but let's see what the deal is with these things. Let's throw this in our hotbar. Nope, they're non-equipable. Use for making Fixmas decorations. So they are a consumable part that we need to make the decorations. So we'll work towards that a little bit further, but we do have our Fixmas tree up. And they did a great job on the render on those. It's a really cool tree. Really cool. Nicely done. All right, back to coal. Okay, quick little recap. We've got all the coal and everything is all brought down here. It feeds in. Both those lines are 90 items per minute coming in on those lines. Goes into this first splitter, splits down 45 that way, and then 45 continuing this way, that then feeds down into that foundry. And then we have the second line comes down over to here, comes into this 45 down here, 45 down that way. So that takes care of the coal. We have the iron in place. Now it's just a matter of making sure all of this is powered up. So I've got power lines running. So I'm going to hook up our smelters here that are taking care of the excess iron for right now. And then we can look and see where this stuff connects at. So this one connects there. You can connect here. And then we're going to go around all this stuff. I've got so many conveyors. Conveyors, splitters, mergers, all to do load balancing so that we can have the right amount of materials going into these machines. Bang! Okay, we've got everything all hooked up now. These should be cranking away steel ingots. We have steel ingots now coming out of these machines. So look at the pollution those things are puking out. That's brutal. But there we go. We've got steel ingot manufacturing happening. Now it's time to see, okay, what is next? Obviously, we need to be looking at various steel, at different steel productions that are happening. So let me, I think that all comes down into various constructors and stuff and assemblers. So, because I think the only thing we really got new was the foundry. So let's just throw down a constructor here real quick. And just see what all it takes to get things, get the steel stuff up and working. So, what do we got? We got steel beams. That takes 60 ingots to be able to make steel beams. And that produces 15 of them. So, 60 ingots going into that. Let's grab another recipe here. And then we've got steel pipe. Steel pipe is 30 ingots. Hey, you know what? That works out to 90 exactly. So if we take two of these, merge them, and then split off, come up with a splitter solution so that, actually, how would that work? Yeah, we would come up with a splitter solution out here so that we could build 60 going one way and 30 going to another side. We'll have to play with that a little bit to see how we can get our... I think that's easy because it would be like a three-way splitter and then merging two of those lines together to get our 60 on one side and 30 on the other so that we can have two of those manufactured. And we might be able to do that like on both of these because I think both of those end up being required to make other options here. So that's steel beams and steel pipe. So now I think it's an assembler we need to look at for the other options. So let's look at an assembler real quick. I'm going to throw one of these down on the ground. I'm just putting them willy-nilly here just so we can kind of make sure that we've got what we want. So this is making versatile framework is what we're looking at here. And this requires 25 modular frames. As well as steel beams to get that. Well, modular frames. Okay, so that's everything that we're manufacturing over on that side of the plant is our modular frames. But I don't necessarily know that I want all of them to come over here. So I wonder if there's something I can do with this 60 iron. See, it took us 120 iron over there to be able to make it, but we had a little bit of excess waste. So I'll try and see if I can plan out something with the 60 iron per minute that's coming in here. To see if we can have another modular frame construction getting done up here. But in the meantime, let us continue with our manufacturing here. Okay, we have everything all powered up here. We have beam construction, pipe construction, and pipe construction. They are all feeding out into these two mergers, so all the pipes are combining into this one line. Sorry, all the beams are combining into this one line, and all the pipes are connecting into this one line. And they all feed directly into these two machines here. So now we're starting to stockpile pipes and beams off of our steel production. Now we need to kind of run back and have a look and see, okay, what do we need to be able to complete the rest of our tiers? All right, I've run back up to the hub here, and let's see what we can do to finish unlocking tier 3. And tier 3 looks like it's modular frames, which I have a bunch of, a bunch of rotors, which I've already got, and then the copper cabling, and I'm short on iron rods, so I've just got to run down and grab some iron rods. I'll be right back. One thing I wanted to do before I run down and grab those iron rods is I wanted to come back up here and look at, I want to say it was the sulfur construction, because I have some copper on me now, which we needed, or not copper, coal. I got coal on me now, so that we need 50 sulfur and 25 coal. We can research that, and that is going to expand down on our, I'm going to say, blasting trees. So what we're still volatile, we have to make 50 of these volatile applications. Well, what does it take to make those? Let's quickly have a look at that in our little mixing here. So basically that's making black powder is what we've got to be making. It's one coal and two sulfur to make them, and we need to make 50. That's something that we can construct later. I might actually look at like maybe having an assembler up here that's just for these kind of smaller one-off things, is a basic little assembler up here that we can just be hand throwing materials in as we get them to be able to construct this stuff to turn in for our research. All right, we've made it back to the hub, and we should have everything we need to be able to turn this in. Let's select our milestone. That is modular frames. That's rotors, cabling, and iron rods. Launch away. That is another milestone, and
milestone reached.
Tier 3 is complete.
As well as the construction of outposts is now encouraged. Vehicle stations have built-in functionality to refuel and restock or collect parts.
So vehicle stations, that's probably going to be under, I'm going to think, logistics? Is that a logistics thing? No, transportation. It's got its own tree. And so we can make a truck station and a tractor that we can have. These could be programmed. They carry 25 slots, has a built-in crafting bench, can be automated to pick up and deliver resources at truck stations. Nickname the Sugar Cube by Fix Pioneers, with the justification is it's pretty sweet, you know. That's what they actually have in their little text description for it here. And then a truck station is either send or receive resources to vehicles, has an inventory with 48 slots in it, transfer up to 120 stacks per minute to and from docked vehicles. It is a really fast way to transport information or stuff around. It's just getting that whole, you know, plant. When we really start getting out there, the stuff we've been bringing into our plant right now, it's been less than 1,000 meters is where we've been pulling everything from. So to spend that time, it's not been really that crazy having to run conveyors and stuff. But if we start getting into the kilometers of distance that needs to be traveled, we're probably not going to want to do that with conveyors, even though that would look really cool to have all these conveyors everywhere. This is where the trucks will come into play for us to be able to do that. So, of course, they do require fuel, and I believe they are coal powered, so we need to make sure that we've got a regular supply of coal that they can pick up from, because they can grab coal and deliver it for their fueling and stuff. So that's things we got to keep in mind as well. So let's do a quick recap of where we're at with this episode. So the goal here was to get our tier 3 all unlocked, which I think we did a fine job of getting that done. I'm just going to climb over our elevator here so we can get a better view, if there is a way to climb over this. I'm not entirely sure there is a way to get around this thing. Oh, well, that's not going to be a good view. That hurt. We'll go up onto our, we'll put up a, I should put up another view tower over here. All right, I've set up another guard tower, observation tower, whatever you want to call these things. And we are up top here, and now we get a little bit better view of kind of what we've done down here. So all the way over there, we have four normal nodes of iron that we are pulling from. That is being conveyed on two conveyors. They're getting merged together into two, basically what would be pure lines on there at 120 items per minute are flying down here. And then we hit a spaghetti of mergers and splitters and everything to optimize our output. So basically each one of the foundries require 45 items. That's a total of 90 per side. Well, getting to that point is a little bit on the tricky side. So basically we did a three-way split on one of these points here. Actually, I think what I did is I went 60 down over to this merger, 60 into that splitter that then sent 30 that way and 30 into the merger, which gave us our 90. And then it split again to go 45 and 45. And then the second line, we did the exact same thing with this setup to be able to get them. We took those 30, they're just getting made into iron ingots right now. Eventually, those I'm probably going to turn into manufacturing whatever plate we need for doing another modular frame assembly, because eventually we need to get to those steel frames, and those are gonna require modular frames for those. And so we're gonna need another reinforced plate manufacturing and all that stuff over here. I've decided I'm just gonna pull the screws and pull the bars from our storage that we've got over here. Cause we've got a lot. We've got room that we could send some of the stuff that's over here over to the manufacturing for being able to make whatever steel stuff we need. So I'm not worried about having to have enough iron ingots coming off this. We'll make more plate. We'll definitely do that with the plate for sure. Then the next thing we got is we've got our coal coming down here at 180 items per minute on two conveyors. We have one Mark II conveyor and one Mark I conveyor that are coming down. And then we do a little swap down here where we do a split and merge so that we turn them both into 90 item per minute lines that are coming in here. That one of them feeds these two, because this require 45 coal per minute, into here, and then the other one feeds here in splits and to give us 45 per item. And then we're coming out of them and they're getting merged together into one line, giving us our 90 steel ingots per minute on both lines. Then when we get down to steel beams required 60 items, and steel pipes required 30 items. So we basically took that 90, we split it three ways, merged two of them together to give us 60 items per minute into the assembler for the steel frame, did the same thing here. And then we sent 30 into this production line, 30 into here. So that gave us this little spaghetti. There we're taking the lines of the various productions, merged them together, and they're getting moved into storage just down below us here. So that's where we got to. And I think, you know what, I'm trying to get a goal of, ultimately I want like a 30 to 35 minute episode. I'm really thinking I'm going to be kind of close here with it. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop here. We've also, of course, tier 3 is completely unlocked now. Our goals for next time is going to be working towards unlocking or finishing up tier 4. That's our ultimate goal in the next step here, is busting into tier 4 milestones and starting to crank some of those out. With that said, reach down, hit the like button on this video, subscribe if you are new to the channel. Also, follow me on Instagram and Twitter, because I do post over there when I've uploaded a video or when I've got live streams coming up. So make sure you guys reach down and check that. And you can check out my merch shop at terracedwdc.com. And with that all said, you guys have a fantastic one, and we'll see you in the next one.